Yeah, we are celebrating the best and the most important venue here in Washington, D.C., but also because this is going to be performing by the Paso Pan American Symphony Orchestra, which is conducted by our friends of our embassy. The conductor is Sergio Busles, an Argentinian who lives here in Washington, D.C. And the orchestra is composed of more than 20 musicians, very prestigious and wonderful musicians. I can only mention, as an example, Diana Legrand in violin, Rodolfo Zanetti, Javier Sanchez in bandoneon, and Dorothea Rags in cello. So I just wanted to thank you all again for coming. Let's enjoy together National Day of Tango and Merry Christmas for everyone. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Thank you, and happy National Tango Day. That was Preludio Nochero by somewhat contemporary of Astor Piazzolla. And now we're going to go back in time and do Pichuqueando. Pichuqueando is a composition by one of the bandoneons on the Aníbal Troilo Tango Orchestra. And he stayed with Aníbal Troilo from the beginnings of the orchestra until Aníbal Troilo's death in 1975. And he was from the Republic of Rosario of Argentina. Pichuqueando. Thank you. That was Adios Bardi from the orchestra of Osvaldo Pugliese. And now we're going to go from Argentina to Denmark and play Celos or Jealousy by Jacob Gades. I forgot to present my lovely concertmaster, Diana Legrand on violin. And now Actually, the musicians asked me to talk at this point because the next tango is in a weird, really weird key change, and they need to adjust their brains. Ojos Negros is probably one of the oldest tangos that we're going to play tonight. It was written around 1905 by Vicente Greco. And this version is from the 1970s Troilo Orchestra. Thank you. By Francini, Tema Otoñal. Again, another transcription from the Aníbal Troilo Orchestra. Now we're going to play the only Astor Piazzolla piece tonight, and that will be Prepárense. This is one of the very first pieces of Astor Piazzolla that actually he arranged this one for the Aníbal Troilo Orchestra. And it's a little bit different than the Piazzolla that we used to listen and hear. If you are not tired of tango, we have a couple of concerts coming up. February 28th is jazz meets tango. Oh, not the 28th, the 18th, sorry. And then the tango festival in April, up here in the Kennedy Center.
Thank you.
going to the part that you're probably hearing a lot of exchanges, sounds coming from this side of the orchestra. I do this in every concert, so if it's because in the tango orchestra you don't have percussion instruments. So we only have violins, bandoneons, pianos, cellos, basses, and so they have to make noise, other percussive instrument noises with their instruments. Some of them are the chicharra, the látigo or whip, and the tambor. That's the tambor, and that sounds like a drum. Also, we have whistles, like the wolf whistle when a pretty lady comes by. And the bass sometimes hits the that you can hear in the first piece. The next piece, En Pampa y la Vía, it needs a little bit of an introduction because En Pampa y la Vía is a saying that we have in Argentina when you have no money. You are in Pampa y la Vía. And that was old time in Buenos Aires. La Vía is where the train tracks are, and Pampa was a street, and that's where all the slums in Buenos Aires used to be. So these are two guys, composers, Damián Torres and Pablo Jaurena. They are from Córdoba, and they just composed this piece about a couple of years ago, En Pampa y la Vía. Thank you. to say that hello to the Cordoba people, because I think they're watching us on internet. Paris Otoñal. Paris Otoñal is a piece written by José Libertella. José Libertella was the bandoneon player of the Sexteto Mayor. And he wrote this piece for, I don't know if you remember, Tango Argentino, that big show in the 80s. That was the orchestra touring with them. And he wrote this, it was Paris, and in the fall, so Paris Otoñal, with a big bandoneon solo at the beginning by Rodolfo Zanetti. Paris Otoñal. Thank you. The next piece is by a friend of us, Octavio Lunetti, and that's it. Thank you. Thank you. I think we have time for one more, no? Yes. Our last piece of the evening. And don't forget, February 18th, if you like jazz and tango, just go upstairs to the Terrace Theater, Jazz and Tango with the Pan American Symphony, and Chase Lounge, and a bunch of other soloists. Our last piece, Canaro en París. And Canaro en París, they wrote this tango because he went to Paris to cash his money that Parisians were crazy with the tango, his tangos. And he had made a lot of royalty, and he tried to cash them, and they kind of stiffed him, and he had to stay there and save to get back on a boat. And so he wrote this. No, he didn't write, but somebody else wrote Canaro en París. Don't forget the April concert. Thank you.